Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to another video. So in the last video I pretty much showed you guys how I traded my 335. Oh. Yo, what's up guys, welcome back to another video. In the last video I showed you guys how I traded my Honda CRZ for the BMW 335i. I told you guys I was gonna start working on it, and I am. So I ended up lifting up the car. It's gonna get the subframe dropped. Waiting on some parts right now. Just wanted to make sure that the car is running perfect for the upgraded turbos that it does have, so that's gonna be awesome. I am gonna get the car retuned and hopefully make north of 500, maybe low 500s. Yeah, but that's not what today's video is about. Today's video is about the CRV's missing, right? I ended up trading the CRV. I pretty much got lucky. Some guy messaged me when I traded the 335i. I was the one looking for the trade, but this time someone messaged me and they told me they wanted the car, and they offered me this car. Let me show it to you guys. Bam. So we got a 2000, I believe it's a 2004, I'm not even completely sure, I need to check the papers again, but Volkswagen GTI. It's got a pretty much full bolt-ons. It's on a stage 2 tune. I'll show you guys a little bit of the interior. So I haven't cleaned it at all, just, you know, you guys know the routine. Show you guys what it looks like when I get them. And yeah, so it is a 5-speed. It came with a really sick Alpine touchscreen right here. There is one major problem though. So when I first got the car and I was about to drive it home, the owner told me that there was a third gear grind and it was because of the bushings, right? Started getting a little unconfident, but I was already 2-3 hours out, so I had to drive the car anyways, right? And luckily it made it all the way home, but right when I was like down the street, maybe 5 minutes, the car just wouldn't shift into any gear, which lets me know, well, it didn't let me know because I didn't know anything about the car. So I had to look it up. After I looked it up, I found out that the bushings are a really, really common occurrence on these. So, yeah, the bushings are bad. Like, it will not let me shift into any gear, even after pressing the clutch. Clutch feels great. I'm not even sure if it's going to be the tranny. I really hope that it's not. Hoping that these bushings will fix the issue. At least that's what the reviews on the bushings said. So, yeah, I mean, the car has a lot lower miles than the CRV. The CRV had like 210,000. This one has 140,000. When I did drive it home and it was driving good, the only problem was you couldn't really get into third. But first and second just pulled really hard. The car felt like really, really good. It felt quicker than the 335i. I don't know if it's because the car's so much lighter or what it is. But, I mean, I'm excited to get this thing running. I just hope that it's not the tranny. If it's a tranny, I don't care, because it's not as expensive as other cars. And I'm going to do the work myself. But it is a huge pain in the ass to be waiting and, like, waiting for the parts. And then having to drop everything, install it, get dirty, put everything away. And, like, yeah, I just don't want to do it. But if it has to get done, it will. And, yeah, let me show you guys a little bit more of the back seat. It has a sunroof. So that's cool. I'm excited for that. Let me show you guys underneath the hood. Alright, so I'm not gonna lie and tell you guys that I know exactly what's going on, because I really don't. I just saw this table too. Not sure if the guy was working on it before he sold it to me. But yeah, maybe someone here knows what they're looking at. He told me these were upgraded coils. The turbo's back here. So I can't see what turbo that is. I don't know if it's OEM. The car doesn't sound like OEM turbo, but like I said, I don't know much about these cars. Big ass intake. So the problem with the bushings is down here, but that'll be for another video. Yeah, you guys, just want to show you guys the other daily, or the other project. Hopefully I can crank some videos out. There's definitely gonna be some DIYs. Like, I already ordered the part right here. It's called the Deiselgeeks bushings. So those are definitely on the way. I mean, they're already here. My bad. I have them upstairs. So I'm going to make a video installing those, and that'll probably be the next video for you guys. The parts for the 335i are still going to be a few days. So, yeah. Hopefully we can get them both running, and it's going to be some really dope videos coming, you guys. So make sure you subscribe, and hopefully you guys are enjoying the content. Catch you on the next one. Peace.